everyone. My name is Sean Clanahan. I'm the director here at the high school. You can't see me now, but I can see you. Hello. Welcome to everybody online. This is the Spring Hermiston High School Showcase. And to start off, we are going to have our Hermiston High School Saxophone Quartet come out and perform a medley from Spirited Away. We have a surprise treat up next. This is not on the program. We're going to bring out Keegan Killison. Keegan competed at the State Soul Ensemble Competition in Washington at the Central Washington University. They called it that. And he performed on the snare drum and placed third in the whole state. Shostakovich. This is based on an orchestral work by Dmitri Shostakovich, the 20th century Russian composer who lived under Soviet rule and wrote some awesome music and fought the power and all that stuff. And okay. May not think that the snare drum could take the place of a string orchestra, but Keegan's about to show you that a mostly working snare drum can in fact sound like a string orchestra. Thank you. Harvard tonight. We have one more solo performance for you this evening. We have a guitar student, Trent Hall, who is going to perform a piece of music written back in the 16th century. So, back in the time of William Shakespeare, this would have been all over Spotify, if Spotify existed. This is from an English composer named John Dowland, who wrote a lot of fantastic music. And one day Trent, about a month and a half ago or so, Trent was sitting out in the hall just jamming away, because he practices a lot. He's gotten really good at the guitar in the last year. And he was just sitting out in the hall at the school, working on I can't remember what. And I walked past and was like, Trent, you should play a solo. Do you want to for the concert? Yeah, sure. So I went into my office, I printed him out a solo, gave it to him, and he spent the last month and a half working up this. This is What If a Day or a Month or a Year by John Dowland. Ensemble and play Augmented Realities. So this is a strange piece of music. It's called Sushi Funk. Funk is a 70s style of music based on a lot of syncopated 16th note rhythms. Think like disco. Sushi is a Japanese delicacy. It takes raw fish, rice, sometimes other ingredients, roll it up. That's not my kind of sushi. Some people eat that kind of sushi. And you mix the two together and you get sushi funk. So please enjoy nigiri, sashimi, sushi, and earth, wind, and fire. This is sushi funk.
Thank you.
I hope you saw the connection with that last piece of music between sushi and Earth, Wind, and Fire. We tried to make it really clear. Okay, this is the guitar ensemble, and we're going to do three charts for you. I'm really excited to share the last one. I think it's going to be awesome. You're going to love it. First one is Purple Haze, and it's the Jimi Hendrix song. And we've got three parts for this one. Actually, we have three parts for our first two, Purple Haze and Royals. And I'm really proud of this group, of what they've been able to accomplish this year. It's been a lot of fun working with them, and most of these kids at the beginning of the year started out with little to no experience with guitar, and I think in the last year they've picked up a lot of information, and I hope that they can use it moving forward and keep playing guitar, keep playing music, and use this as a stepping stone to pursue anything, any area of music that they might wish to pursue. So. Before we get started, can we give a big round of applause for the guitar? Here's some Jimi Hendrix. Thank you. Festival, and the group that did the lunchtime performance for the concert for all the groups there was the Chihuahua High School Mariachi group and Hacienda del Sol. They are a phenomenal mariachi group. Got a chance to see and play them, or play with them, quite a few times, and they're outstanding. Kids loved it, and they were all jazzed about wanting to do mariachi. Everybody was asking me, Mr. Planham, Mr. Planham, can we have a mariachi group? I said, well, we need another music teacher, because I don't have time. But, so I was thinking about it, and I was able to scrounge around on the internet, and I found a free version of this song that I thought was approachable for us, and it's a song called La Ley del Monte, or La Ley del Montaña. I probably butchered that, and I apologize. And it, with the full complement of instruments, it's got violins, it's full string orchestra, trumpets, vocals, and guitars, and it's really nice. You should look it up on YouTube. And we were able to bring in two trumpets from the Wind Ensemble. This is Jacob Culligan and Jonathan Sanchez. And we were able to expand the sound of the guitar class. We had noticed some students moved over to our electric bass and our guitar. Is the guitar up and working? Nope. Okay. Mostly just stalling. It always helps when you plug it in. How does an astronaut put its baby to sleep? He rocked her. Okay, Karen, how does the joke go? Put a baby astronaut to sleep. You rock it. Okay, Zakai, are you ready? Okay, here is Lake Del Monte, and you're in for a treat. It's going to be cool. Concert band, you are up next. Thank you. So with that last piece of music, we were working a lot with playing slowly and lyrically, which is really hard with a wind instrument, and we had a chance to experiment with some keys that we don't often play in band music, which mean that the students have to play with a lot of different patterns that they're not used to on their instruments. So it's a really good learning opportunity for them. This next piece of music is called Lost in Mammoth Cave, and we are going to bring up a guest conductor. This is Leslie Mendoza Romero, and she is working with, she's been working with the fourth period class, the concert band, all year as a peer tutor, and has done a lights out phenomenal job the entire year. And she has agreed to take on this challenge of conducting and rehearsing a piece of music with this group, and she's done phenomenal. So here is Leslie Mendoza with Lost Man. Symphonic Bandura. Next piece of music is called Cumberland Cross, and I really like this piece of music because it makes me want to go out and just build a barn. It's like totally Americana, East Coast, Aaron Copland. It's just fun to play. Hope you enjoy this, and in between between our two pieces of music, we are going to feature or honor some seniors from band. And then we are going to bring up another guest conductor. So here is Cumberland Cross.
Thank you.
go to Safeway and buy 18 chocolate bars today. I'm sure she got a lot of strange looks, but she's fantastic. First up, could I have, we're going to honor two seniors in this group. There are more seniors in Wind Ensemble, and some of them also perform in this group, but because of how this technology works, it's easier just to use your name. So, can I have Maria Rojo Aguirre? So just so you all know, my tradition, when seniors graduate from band and they go out into the real world and they get to have jobs and income and all that, and they're going to find that they're going to have money to buy coffee. And I used to buy a coffee card and a chocolate bar, but, you know, inflation and... it got expensive, so I just cut it back to the chocolate bar. So, because there's 16 seniors or 18, no, there's a lot, and that's a lot. So I got chocolate bars. That's pretty good. So anyway, I'm sure you're going to get coffee cards, all you seniors out there, for graduation. So while you're sitting in your coffee shop drinking your new adult coffee. Okay, because that's what adults drink. You can eat pretentious chocolate, right? That's what being an adult is all about. It's not about Hershey's chocolate, okay, or the Kit Kat bars. No. You need to eat precocious, pretentious chocolate with weird flavors. That's what adults are all about. So, you get to choose. There's a lot of stuff in here. We've got Ghirardelli, raspberry, there's intense orange, there's... almond and sea salt, there's 72% cacao. Choose wisely. There's a lot of good choices. But before you do that, this is Maria. Maria's parents' names are Elba Aguirre and Yelmero Rojo. Apologies. What are your plans? Her plans for next year are to start her nursing prerequisites at BMCC and then transfer to Wazoo Tri-Cities and graduate with a bachelor's in nursing. Her favorite memory for band is my daily dad jokes and getting drenched at Silverwood last year. Maria. For next year are to go to BMCC and hopefully become a diesel mechanic. His favorite memory for band is going to Silverwood and spending time with his friends in band. This is Okay, more conductor up. This is Alexandria McClure, and she is doing the same setup that Leslie did with the concert band, only with the symphonic band. So she had the choice, or she got to pick out a piece of music and work with the symphonic band on it. And I think it's been a really good experience. She's done really well with it. She wants to go into music education. Without further ado, this is Joy Revisited.
Thank you.
early 20th century, there was an English composer named Gustav Holst, who one of my trombones is named after Gustav, but anyway. He wrote an orchestral piece of music entitled The Planets, and he went through all of the known planets at that time. Pluto was not a known planet, and it still at this time is not a known planet, sorry. And he wrote a movement for everything in the solar system except for Earth, because there's so many things about Earth. He didn't want to write another one. But they weren't the planet looked like, or what life might be like on the planet. It was the astrological symbol of each planet. So Mars, if you all know from your like Greek mythology or Roman mythology, had to do with
war.
So this is the first movement of the planets, and it is titled Mars, Bringer of War, and this is about an army coming to the battlefield and then wreaking havoc. It's awesome. Here is Mars, Bringer of War.
Thank you.
Courses in marine biology. inviting a percussion section to her house for a drumline plus pit plus Zane hangouts that involve the fire pit, movie nights, and candy poker. And baseline hangouts during her last ever marching band season. Sabrina Sutter. CBC and become a dental hygienist. And her favorite memory from band is McClanahan trying to help me with my chemistry homework, but taught her everything she knows.
Absolutely nothing.
Rose Parra. Kaylee or does. Kaylee's parents are Salvador Ordaz and Esperanza Garcia. Her plans for next year are to attend Portland State University and major in business and international and global studies. Her favorite memory from band was freshman year when we went to Eugene for marching band and had to fall asleep while Maria Tejeda was telling scary stories. And that was funny in the morning. So, a lot of good marching band stories. Kaylee Ordaz. Sorry, you should have turned in your form earlier. What a grand spirit. There's still a lot of 72% cacao. The best way. Okay. We are going to play Elements. The first two movements, and they are based on the elements that you find on Earth: air, wind, water, fire. And if you watched Captain Planet when you were a kid, art. Here is Elements. Thank you. and cruel Susan. Next up is Karen Cardenas. Karen's parents are Jamie and Ivan Cardenas. Plans for next year are to attend the University of Wisconsin, Green Bay, and major in arts and management. Go Packers, yeah. Favorite memory from band, I should have read this beforehand, she warned me about it, was all of them because each memory made us a family. Just kidding. Her favorite one was roasting Mr. McClanahan, for example, rating his outfit because they would be at an average of 4 out of 10, 6 out of 10, or at best, but just to be nice, his outfit tonight is a 7 out of 10. Because, of course, she would be a 10 out of 10. Karen Cardenas. Send you my therapy, though. Alexandra McClure. Favorite memory from band is when a certain person was playing Pokemon Go while they were on the bus and freaked out because he was seeing the Columbia River on the map. He woke everyone up because he was yelling a lot. Oh, he thought it was the ocean. That is a big body of water. It's either that or the time everyone was leg wrestling on the grass at some random truck stop, like you do. Alexandra McClure. Just so you know, parents out there, we always advocate for safe activities at truck stops. Xavier Mina. Esparza and Benito Molina. Plans for next year are to go to BMCC and earn his associates, then transfer to Western Governors University and earn a bachelor's degree in software engineering. Favorite memory from band is to qualify for state solo ensemble on the tenor saxophone, making new friends, getting to pick out a piece for the wind ensemble this year, and shout out to the saxophone section, the best section it says. Xavier Mina. Favorite memory from band are the memories of hanging out with classmates after and during events, especially the Silverwood trip last year. Brent Kelly. Justine Rodriguez. for next year is to continue to work in the healthcare field while attending WSU. Favorite memory from band is going on the Silverwood trip last year. Justine. Everett Wicks. Photographer on the side. His favorite memory from band, this was a day I will remember for a long time, was when they were in distance learning, that silly thing we had to do two, 3 years ago, and noticed that Mr. McClanahan hadn't closed the link after class at the end, which meant that it was just open and anybody could join and do whatever they wanted. Anyway, so naturally, he got all of his friends together and started playing multiplayer Minecraft in the class and helping the confused students that join with their music questions. And then I came in from doing whatever, like 40 minutes later, I think it was I was on my lunch break or something like that, and sat down at the computer, and sure enough, like four people playing Minecraft. Oh, it was a fun time. Everett Wicks. So, yeah. Thank you. Favorite memory from band is when we, the seniors, grabbed a bunch of boxes and gave Mr. McClanahan a new joke book. It's a good book. It's a good book. JJ. Two left. I've got almond and with a touch of honey and intense orange. No, they're mine. So I would be remiss. If I didn't thank all of the seniors for four fantastic years going through distance learning, going through. All of the chaos that was last year, trying to work their way back into it, and they stuck it out. And they've done a tremendous job. They've been fantastic leaders in the group. Can we give the seniors, can we stand up, seniors? We have wondered that call. Studies program in music, which and that was a big undertaking for all 4 years of high school, and they get to wear these stoles at graduation on top of their gowns. Yeah. Okay. So, without further ado, this is our last number that we're going to play. This is Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa. And there are going to be some solo sections towards the end. We're going to feature Julissa Mendoza on the piccolo and the brass section. So, thank you very much for coming. Hope you enjoyed yourselves. And this is Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa.
Thank you.
Thursday free. There's a jazz night featuring all the jazz bands from the Hermiston School District, and our music and theater banquet at where we give out all the awards for the year will be on Wednesday, May 31st out at EOTech, and it's going to be a potluck dinner and dessert, so please come out for that. And thank you for all the students that performed tonight. Thank you for parents for being here supporting your children. And I hope you have a wonderful summer and spring. Thank you very much.